If you've ever wanted to know how well optimized your video is or somebody else's on YouTube, stay tuned because we're going on a deep dive on a brand new vidIQ tool.
vidIQ. vidIQ.com.
Hello everyone, welcome to vidIQ. My name is Rob. If this is your first time here, we are the YouTube tool and channel that aims to help you get more views in less time to help grow your channel. One of the ways we do that is through this wonderful vidIQ Chrome extension that you see on screen now. This is the video watch page on YouTube, and if you haven't used vidIQ before, you may be wondering what on earth all of these numbers are and statistics on the right-hand side of the screen. And this is our industry-leading video scorecard, and it unearths all sorts of data about every single video on YouTube, such as views per hour. It also looks at social engagement of videos. We'll even grade your search engine optimization to find out whether videos are as discoverable as they should be. And the video tags here are showing you where tags rank for this particular video. But what we're looking at today is a brand new tool that we're bringing to you. And it comes in the form of this section here, which is the video optimization checklist. Now, I'm a video creator just like you, and one of the most stressful times of any video, especially here at vidIQ, where we upload 3 to 4 videos a week, is the actual uploading process. You've spent hours creating a video, and then in a rush to get the video onto YouTube, you forget to do a custom thumbnail, or you don't write enough tags, it's not optimized properly, or you forget to add the video to a playlist. There's all of these things to think about when it comes to YouTube to help them serve your content to the right audience and have maximum exposure. So what we have here is the video optimization checklist, which for your own videos includes 15 different points for you to refer to. Now, each of these checkpoints are indicated by a green tick or a red cross. For example, if you haven't added the video to a playlist, you will get a red cross. If you haven't shared the video to Facebook, you will get a red cross. However, for titles, tags, and descriptions, it's slightly different. We rate your metadata, so to speak. For example, with a title, if it's less than 20 characters or more than 60 characters, we will give you a red cross because for a title, you need some keywords in there. So that would be at least a phrase of some kind over 20 characters. But once you go over 60 characters, that will cut off your title in some previews. So the viewer may not be able to read the entire title before clicking on the video. As with tags, tags are always used to help categorize your content, give YouTube a little bit more information about where the video should go and who it should be served to. So you should include at least 200 characters worth of tags, which may be long tail or short tail keywords. Make sure you include enough of them to get the green tick. The maximum is, of course, 500 characters for tags. As for descriptions, the first 3 or 4 lines are vitally important to YouTube in terms of, again, looking at those keywords of your content and being able to index them correctly in searches. And again, when you show those thumbnail previews and description previews, those first few lines are red. So we suggest having at least 300 characters. The rest of the checkpoints are very much make sure you do all of these things when you upload a video. For example, video cards. You want to push your audience to more of your content to increase session watch time. The same with end screens. Your content doesn't have to end with the conclusion of your video. Make sure you're pushing your audience to more of your content. Closed captions. These help YouTube with indexing your content. It will search for keywords and it could help with translations as well. Reply to comments, obviously very important for improving engagement. When somebody sends something to you, asks a question, they've put some time and effort into that. You should put time and effort into engaging with your audience. Sharing on Facebook and sharing on Twitter, obviously you want to share it on other social media platforms. You may do this in slightly different ways. So if you don't share to Twitter or Facebook directly from YouTube, that's not too much of a concern if you have another plan of action when it comes to that. Monetization enabled, obviously that's something you'll be wanting to do if making an income stream from your content is important to you. Added to a playlist. All videos should be added to some form of playlist and you should be adding a playlist on a regular basis. people watching videos within playlists are pushed to more of your content. Again, it ups the watch time. Making a video public goes without saying, obviously. You may have set one of your live streams to unlisted, so it's worth checking that just in case you've made that mistake. And of course, more engagement options down at the bottom here. Making sure that you've either pinned one of your own comments to add more information about the video, or pinning your favorite comments from your audience. That really does inspire them when you do that. And of course, if you're going to read the comments, you want to heart them. It sends a notification to the viewer and they feel good about themselves that the video creator has taken time to read their comments. So that's what the video optimization checklist looks like for one of your own videos. How does that differ to a video that's not one of your own? If we visit this vidIQ tutorial from Sean Cannell at Think Media, thank you very much, Sean, for the awesome tutorial. The scorecard is on the right-hand side, as we can see, but if we scroll down to the video optimization checklist, it includes 10 checkpoints, not 15. Some of the data that we collect is private to your own content, so we only share it on your videos, but this content here is public. The ones that you won't see on other people's videos are custom thumbnails, closed captions, reply to a recent comment, the monetization enabled checkpoint, and added to a playlist. These are all private things to your channel, which is why we don't share them on other people's channels. But as we can see here, Sean at Think Media, big thumbs up, of course. He's an expert at YouTube optimization, and he has more or less perfectly optimized his video. Not shared it on Twitter. Maybe he's done that through different sources or used a different link which can't be detected through our checklist. So that's how a near perfect video is optimized. But what we haven't looked at yet is when a video hasn't been optimized at all. And it looks a little like this. So right now, this video is an absolute dumpster fire, but we can save it because it hasn't been published yet. We need to add cards, end screen, custom thumbnails, all sorts of things need to be fixed here. And you also see our recommendations for titles, tags, and descriptions. If I mouse over, it will give me a recommendation of putting a title between 20 and 60 characters. It looks like here that it's over 60 characters. Same with tags, we've probably not added any at all. And the description is too short. We haven't done anything with our description that needs fixing. Now, one of the good things we have here on optimization is when you haven't optimized, it provides links with these arrows. So say if I need to add some video cards to this video, I simply click on the arrow and that will automatically take me to the video cards section of this video, so I can then add some cards which will send my audience to more videos on my content. And you can do that with the end screens and other options from the video optimization checklist. Now for some awesome news. Everything you've seen so far in this optimization checklist is 100% free when you download the vidIQ Chrome extension. There is one paid aspect to this optimization checklist, and this is for Pro and Boost users, and that is the controversial keywords checker. Now, if I look at another person's video, such as Sean Cannell's again, we have a potential controversial keyword here, which is the word shoot. And he's included that in his video description here. So it's just a warning that your content may be flagged for demonetization when you include some of the words that we have in our controversial keywords checker. And there are plenty more, what you might describe as saucy comments in there. So it's not a de facto, this will be a demonetized warning. It's a guide to make sure that if you are using particular words, how YouTube may interpret them. So there you have it, folks, the video optimization checklist tool. Not only an opportunity to audit your own content, but to spy on your competition as well, all from the YouTube watch page. We'd love to hear your thoughts on this tool. Let us know in the comments below. And of course, this is all part of the vidIQ Chrome extension. A link is in the description, and it is, as we said, free to download. Enjoy the rest of your video making day. Bye for now.